primetime atmosphere on this Saturday morning in Houston. The biggest football game in school history awaits. The Houston football program has seen the spotlight before. The high-powered offenses, high rankings, and a Heisman Trophy winner. But never like this. Kevin Sumlin's team today goes for a BCS bowl berth, a conference title, and a 13-0 record. It's also the final home game for Case Keenum, whose legacy will include a laundry list of passing records.
Keenum down the middle. Touchdown! Case Keenum lays out another beautiful long ball. Back to passes. Keenum looking for the end zone. He's got a touchdown!
But standing in the way is 10-2 Southern Miss with their own outstanding quarterback, Austin Davis. The Conference USA title and much more on the line today in Texas. And here come the Cougars. Capacity crowd here at this venerable old ballpark. Mike Patrick, Craig James, great to have you with us. History awaits the Cougars this afternoon. 13-0, a BCS bowl bid. They can see the end of the rainbow from here. The question is, can they get there?
When you own the pot of gold, you can get there. And that's Case Keenum. Case Keenum this year has electrified the country. Watching what he's done with his arm has been really special. This young man has set most all records passing in NCAA history. For me, when I look at the last seven games, the 29 touchdown passes are a reflection of what he's done in getting the ball in his playmakers' hands in space so they can continue to run the yards after the catch. He throws all the balls. 47 throws this year of over 25 yards. So he is electric. He's exciting. And this crowd feeds off of that. So does this team.
Southern Mississippi comes in at 10-2. This is a good football team. Are they good enough to keep up in what promises to be a track meet?
They have to match the firepower of the University of Houston. And they have a quarterback who's very capable. Austin Davis has a lot of records. This young man leads an offense that can score as well. You look at the numbers. Statistically, he's close to Case Keenum. 77 touchdowns in his career. So he knows how to get the ball into the end zone. Over 10,000 career yards throwing. That's why I say Austin Davis has to match the firepower of Case Keenum. He has the ability. Can he do it on the field?
In the first surprise that we've had in this ballgame, Southern Miss won the coin toss. You would expect them to receive because you want to score first against Houston, but they decided to defer to the second half. It does give them the advantage of a wind, which is 16 miles an hour, gusting to 27. Tyron Carrier, one of the best kick returners ever, deep for Danny Rapman's kickoff. 5 yards deep, he'll keep it there.
Keenum's had such an unbelievable career here, and for him to be able to come back from a severe knee injury has been rewarding both personally for him and uplifting for this University of Houston football program.
I mean, there are so many numbers involved with Case Keenum, but the one that jumps out to me, 43 touchdown passes and 3 interceptions. Are you kidding? 3 interceptions? You would think just with the number of times they throw tip balls, he would have more than that. Sims and Hayes are the two backs. And Keenum to Sims in the flat. And Sims taken down on a nice tackle by Jerrion Johnson, the sophomore spur linebacker.
Yeah, that's an uncharacteristic throw right there because Keenum normally leads his receivers, allows them to turn right up the field and run and avoid that first tackler.
Up tempo. Keenum double pump. Johnson was open and he missed. These corners are very aggressive. You can beat them with double moves. You saw the little pump fake, and Cotton was toast, but he overthrew Johnson.
Yeah, and you know what? This is a ball that's thrown into a pretty gusting wind, so there'll be a little adjustment from Case Keenum into that wind. Maybe that's why Southern Miss and Larry Fedora decided, I'm going to punt this, kick this ball off and defer to the second half.
Third and 10 for Houston. You do not often see them go three and out, and that's what Southern Mississippi is looking for right now. You got two really good pass rushers on the outside. Keenum forced out of the pocket, chased from behind. Can't find anybody, has to try to run, gets five, and that will be fourth and five. Chased down by Cordero Law, who went across the width of the field to get the Houston quarterback.
Yeah, and you know what? Law is one of those guys, the best pass rusher, has a lot of speed to be able to chase down a quarterback only with a four-man rush, dropping seven. A very successful start for this USM defense.
Richie Leone to punt to Tracy Lampley. He waits at his 35. Great start for the Southern Mississippi defense. The wind holds that one up. Lampley can't even get close to making a fair catch. And then it takes a big bounce in favor of the Golden Eagles. Thanks to EA Sports, here's Craig with the James game.
Well, we're talking about what does Southern Mississippi have to do today to compete in this football game. They have to be diverse. They have the ability, multiple assets. Davis can run the football as well as he can throw it. It's a good asset to have in the backfield. One time he keeps it, the next time he's going to have to pitch the ball. Tracy Lampley, very talented all-purpose player. And then you give it, you fake it, and you throw the play-action pass. That's what they have to do today to keep this ball game close and to keep it away from Case Keenum.
Fake to Desmond Johnson, and Austin Davis goes down in the arms of Sammy Brown. He is the big play guy for this Houston defense.
So much is talked about, and rightfully so, Case Keenum in the offense. But the Houston defense, led by Brian Stewart, I really like the philosophy of Brian Stewart. We'll talk about it throughout the game.
Davis against the four-man rush, throwing with the wind, and it sails over the head of Desmond Johnson, running a wheel route out of the backfield. He was guarded by DJ Hayden.
Yeah, Brian Stewart asked his corners to stop the fade and to come up and support on a quick throw. That wind right there carried the football 5 yards beyond. So like Keenum, Davis is going to have to make an adjustment and figure out how to throw it with the wind behind him.
Davis on the run. Breaks the tackle. First down. Heck of a job by Austin Davis, the senior from Meridian, Mississippi. Got away from Marcus McGraw, who would have had him short of the first down. As it was, he picked up 15 when he needed 13.
Yeah, Desmond Johnson coming out of the backfield, the tailback, and blocking on the quarterback design draw was the difference on that play.
Lampley will get the ball in the read option. Fights his way forward to the 25-yard line. The line to make is the 14. David Hunter made the stop for Houston.
Brian Stewart, the defensive coordinator, he teaches, do your job, have your responsibility. You might make the play, you might not, but if you do your job, then someone else does on that particular play. Right now, with this zone read going on between Davis and his tailback, Johnson, you better do your responsibility. Don't try to do someone else's.
Lampley again. Four more to the 21. So that will bring up third, call it seven. With the wind at their back, they are obviously well within field goal range, but they're not thinking three right now.
And last year in this football game, this Southern Miss football team ran for 350 yards. So they've got an idea and a mindset that we can come out and pound you. Houston's front four has to match the physicality of what Southern Miss is doing.
The more you run, the more time comes off the clock, and the longer Case Keenum is sitting on the bench, which is exactly where you want him. Blitz coming. They pick it up. Davis had time, and it's batted down. Excellent job by the offensive line to pick up the blitz, but Marcus McGraw, the leader of this defense, the leader in tackles with 120 on the year, got the hand up and blocked the ball.
Yeah, very nice job of the timing of coming in there. Davis has to do a better job of delaying that snap, that final hut. Let his offensive line and his back get up there to take on the linebacker.
Danny Ratman, who got off to a slow start but has made 11 of his last 12, will try a field goal from 38 yards. and he missed it. Southern Mississippi squandering a scoring chance in a scoreless first quarter. Like many young couples, Case Keenum and his wife live modestly. Their garage apartment so small it doesn't have a full number for a mailing address. Yesterday, Kimberly gave us a tour of the place they call the Half. That's their address, the Half. And we'll get to that as soon as we can. Sims did not have a chance. What a play by Cordero Law. That's the third time he's been in the backfield, and he has recognized every one of those plays and gone to a spot and waited for the guy.
Yeah, and he's playing to the field, so he's moving around, giving him plenty of green pasture to go cover. Very, very talented player, 6.5 sacks on the year.
And obviously very bright. Pressure coming from behind. It almost got there. Keenum throws. Man wide open, and it's dropped by Tyron Carrier.
Now this is the all-time.
Holy cow.
All-time receptions leader at the University of Houston and Conference USA. Had 307 receptions coming into the game. So it's not like he's used to dropping passes. This Cougar offense now has missed on two big plays down the field. The opening play of the game and that one right there.
What a throw into the wind. Hit him in stride and Carrier couldn't hold it. Will they look back at these plays and say, uh-oh, this was it. Keenum on the run, throws for the sideline, incomplete. Boy, oh boy, what a break for Southern Mississippi that Carrier cannot pull in a perfect throw from Case Keenum.
I think the University of Houston is going to have to do something with Cordero Law. He's putting so much pressure on Keenum. They're going to have to help out Ashworth over on the left side, maybe with the back. They may have to put someone in there. Going empty set is a real advantage for Cordero Law in the pass rush.
Leone to kick. Lampley moving up because the kick's going into the wind again. A terrible kick this time. That one was shanked inside the 40-yard line. That wasn't the wind. That was pressure.
Mike, I got to tell you, as an AP voter, I've got Houston number 5 in the country because they're undefeated. Case Keenum, all that stuff. They're not even close to playing like the number 5 team in the country.
Not right now.
You know, and so this football team's got to pick it up. They got to stop dropping passes. They got to start executing on the special teams. It's just not a good start. It's everything that Southern Mississippi needs to have happen for them in this football game to create the upset and win the championship and keep Houston from playing in a BCS game.
Lampley will make this catch. Fights forward inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. That's going to be enough for the first down. As now they'll mark it at the 26.
Well, that number one is one heck of a player. Tracy Lampley, 126 all-purpose yards, the football game. Last week against Memphis, had 5 for 116 and a touchdown. 5 punt returns, 91 yards. Ran the ball 7 times for 44.
He'll get it on the jet sweep here, trying to get to the outside. Nothing doing.
That's all on him.
Nick Sines, the safety, just forced him wider and wider and wider.
And he's got to learn, though, that at some point you can't outrun containment out there from the corner. You got to cut it up in there and try to run past the pursuit that's coming from behind you. Run scared. Run like somebody's chasing you.
Because they are. And they have evil intentions. Davis looking to the sideline. They need to reach the 16-yard line to keep the drive alive. Straight up the middle, Jamal Woodyard, who has seen his playing time cut short because of ball security issues. He's actually right now the number 4 tailback on this team, but got that carry. And now it's a big third down. Third and 4.
Wouldn't be surprised to see another run. If Houston's not going to have better run support from their linebackers, I'd keep running the football.
Davis throwing for the first down. Bolden has it at the 14-yard line. Bolden is the deep threat on this club. He's their fastest wide receiver. That time they ran him on a short pattern, enough for the first down.
Three receivers to the right, but you keep the back in the backfield. It keeps the threat of the zone read in there.
Davis looks for the end zone into the corner. Nobody even close to it. It was intended for Chris Briggs.
Kevin Sumlin's done a heck of a job this year of keeping his team focused and handling the adversity. The circus atmosphere that's been here at the University of Houston this week about this football game makes you wonder if it didn't maybe get into the minds a little bit of these players. It's natural. You got to assume, and everything's around you. Everybody's talking about you, loving you. It's very hard for a player, if you're not used to that, to overcome it.
He had a great line yesterday. Ignore the circus. Enjoy the ride. Davis fade to the end zone again. Nobody home. Bolden tried to get there, but DJ Hayden, who was a brilliant corner at Navarro Junior College when they won a national title and transferred to Houston, he is a really good effort guy out there in the corner.
I guarantee it. This guy is really good against Tulsa. 8 tackles, a forced fumble, a fumble return. All in all, a fantastic football player. I'm wondering why Southern Mississippi's not running the football. Run the football until they stop the run.
3rd and 10. Houston wants the blitz. Here they come. They pick it up. Davis throws inside the 5. Caught by Ballantyne. Touchdown. 14 yards. Nick Sines missed the tackle that could have prevented the score. And they finally take advantage of that unbelievable field position.
Ballantyne, they call him the best playmaker, as you've said, and it's one of those deals where you get back to the middle of the field and away from those corners on the outside who are really aggressive, very talented.
Seven nothing. Southern Mississippi, after a drive that only had to go 37 yards, they did it in 7 plays.
Because of the balance in the slot, Ballantyne, you're going to see he comes in, back out, settles in the opening. That's a settlement there. And the secondary, Sines has to come up and hug that. He's got that number 2 receiver there. He's got to come hug that route. And there you go, seeing Austin Davis, why he's thrown for over 10,000 yards. Pretty talented arm.
Yes, he is. This one will go 7 yards deep, and Carrier will go out to the 20. That's Carrier in motion. And Keenum rolls in his direction and throws complete up to the 37-yard line to Justin Johnson. Gain of 17.
Really hard to defend that whenever the quarterback's running hard to the left and that trailing number 2 receiver.
Hayes lost his footing, went down at the 40 after gaining 3.
Got a tough cut on that outside foot. Anytime you go with the inside foot, you're going down.
Keenum, little swing to Hayes, and he went down again. He'll lose a couple on this. Collins, number 8, was out there anyway. They have really good bookend defensive ends who can put pressure on the quarterback and get tackles in the backfield. That was a loss of 6.
You see that inside foot, Mike, that left foot, that's the inside foot. You
doesn't
can't
work.
Cut off that. It can't happen. It has to be a foot on the outside, shoulder pads over the feet to cut. And when you do that, back-to-back times, he slipped.
That's it for the first quarter. Houston going for a perfect record in the BCS bid, but they are down 7. One quarter finished here in Houston. The Cougars have the ball. Now with the wind at their back, starting at their own 34-yard line. They have not converted a 3rd down. Keenum pressed. Now in trouble, and down he goes inside the 20. Chased down by Jamie Collins, who's the best athlete on the Southern Mississippi football team. 2 years ago, he was a defensive back. Last year, a linebacker. Now he's a defensive end, and they ask him to do everything. It's a loss of 18 yards.
Five guys to block four. You've got to get it done. Southern Mississippi's defensive line is playing faster and better than the Cougars right now.
Tracy Lampley waits inside his own 45. Leone gets this one out well, but it's end over end and returnable. Lampley. And they missed a block in the back. The crowd just about went crazy because they had a perfect angle from below us to see it. Welcome back to ESPN and ABC. Saturday afternoon college football presented by K Jewelers. 7-0 Southern Mississippi over the number 6 team in the country, the Houston Cougars, going for a perfect 13-0 record and a BCS bid. They're down by a score, and they've been outplayed so far. Davis. Lampley. Boy, that was a slow developing play. Looked like Davis had room to run. Pitched it anyway.
Now, this is a very poor job of execution by Davis. Watch the offensive line create a new line of scrimmage. Watch how far they go up the field. Davis is too deep. He's got to attack the perimeter. He's got to get to the edge on the defensive line. That's a well-executed play by everyone but Davis.
Boy, you're right. The offensive line just blew him off the ball. Lampley, the setback. Davis fakes it to him over the middle, and he's got Ballantyne near the 15-yard line. Check it, it's Quentin Pierce. Gain of 21.
Now he made up for the bad play before that. Now with a nice throw. This here. Now this is just a Southern Mississippi offense that's got some balance going with it. And the University of Houston is playing flat-footed. They're not being aggressive like their coach wants them to be.
Davis has gone over the 3,000-yard mark passing the second year in a row now. He's got Lampley wide open. Touchdown. He faked it to Tracy Lampley, who comes out of the backfield. Nobody went with him. Davis turned, saw him wide open, and floated it to him for a 16-yard score.
The key to the play, though, was Lampley being patient and calm. The play action, he allowed the person responsible for him to check him, thought he was staying, and he went somewhere else, opening up the entire football field.
Ratman knocks that one through, and this crowd is stunned.
Watch the way Lampley kind of just hung around, got to the outside. No problem with Davis throwing that ball into the wind. Very nice job there. Man, hey, now, Case Keenum, here's a Heisman guy. It's his turn. He's got to step up.
Last night, downtown Houston, the mayor's holiday and tree lighting event. Very nice. What a shocker. When you compare these two quarterbacks, Davis 71 yards, Case Keenum only 29 yards in the first half so far. 29. Of course, he did have the two big drops. He could add another 100 right away if they had caught those footballs. Now this is going to be a test for the Houston Cougars. They've been down before and responded. What will they do in this situation? Tyron Carrier is deep. 7 career kick returns for a touchdown. He is tied with C.J. Spiller of Clemson for the all-time record. They go with a pooch kick instead. Picked up by Johnson. And Johnson gets to the 35 before he is game tackled. They come with a 4-man rush. Sims out in the flat wide open. Sims with speed and just pushed out of bounds at the 31. A gain of 34.
Yeah, this is opened up because the slot receiver is going to go to the inside, and he takes away the vision of the linebacker who was going to the outside and responsible for the ball carrier.
Keenum, three-man rush. They drop eight. That ball was partially tipped. Got there anyhow. Johnson made the catch at the 19-yard line. They need to make the 10 for a first down.
You see the different looks, though, that they're presenting. Three-man rush, four-man rush. They've changed it up so many times that it's really confused the offensive line.
This time they come with four. Hayes on the little swing. Got a block on the outside. Hayes dives to the 10-yard line and was taken out right at the sticks. A little swing pass has worked three times on this drive.
Yeah, Southern Mississippi has no answer for that. That has been the play that has worked for the Houston Cougars. Stay with it. Eventually, this Southern Miss defense is going to loosen up on the inside, start chasing out. That'll open your inside ball game.
First down right at the 10. Hayes gets a yard, maybe a yard and a half. And here, to me, Craig, is the area of the field where the aggression of that Southern Mississippi defense can pay off. There's not a lot of room to operate for your offense. They can really hang on those receivers.
Yeah, Marquise Wheaton, one corner, Deron Wilson, the other, very good at playing man-to-man, taking away the fade. So it makes it tougher to score down here. Inside of the field. That's where I'd be looking to see if you could take advantage of something.
Second and goal. Johnson underneath. Johnson to the goal line. Stretches. Touchdown. Well, it took them until there was 7:48 to go in the first half to score, but they get their first one.
Yeah, you saw how quick that happened on the inside. A really good job of Johnson sprinting 3-4 yards, turning around, expecting the ball to be right there. Catch it, turn, and score.
65-yard drive in 11 plays. Matt Hogan for the point after. Keenum came alive on that drive, hit all six of his throws, got better protection, and those swing passes were huge. Johnson barely hung on to the ball long enough.
It's in the books now.
Hasn't bothered him a lot in college, has it? Lampley will let it go. You saw Houston with the big lead in time of possession, a statistic they consider irrelevant. Davis out in the flat, and it's dropped by Desmond Johnson. Looked downfield before he caught it.
We were talking about the wind earlier in this game. Lisa just said that it's not as bad as what the flags show you up top. It looks a lot windier, but it's gusting. You know, it comes and it goes.
We've seen when the ball, it's not a very high rim here at the stadium, when the ball gets up above that rim on the kicks, it's really propelled backwards or forward. Davis in the gun, wants to set up the screen, and it was covered beautifully, so he throws it away. Kelvin King, number 59, a former linebacker that they moved to the defensive line, recognized the screen was out in the middle of it.
Yeah, it's a good job. Again, it almost feels like that the crowd, they sense the opportunity and momentum trying to go over to the Cougar sidelines. This defense has not played fast, has not played aggressive to this point in the game. They need a three and out.
It's finally gotten noisy again in here. Here comes the blitz. Southern Mississippi does a great job of picking it up, and it's almost intercepted. In and out of the hands of Phillip Stewart.
He doesn't miss many. Stewart's a guy that with the 4 interceptions on the season knows how to find where the passing lane's going to be. This ball should have been picked off. They wish they had that one back. But again, it's a 3-and-out. Finally, for the Cougars defense, they stand up and did their job.
3-and-out with only 12 seconds coming off the clock. Edwards, who averages 14 and a half yards a return, waits at his 45-yard line. Bam to kick. Rugby-style kick, giving his teammates a chance to get down the field. Low line drive kick, fair catch at the 38. A 41-yard punt and no return.
The more snaps with success that offensive line has, the better they feel, and it starts tiring that D-line.
Keenum straight down the middle of Johnson. Justin Johnson to the one. 50 yards on the quick little throw from Keenum.
Watch the linebacker as he moves to the inside. The safety is late and loses the leverage. That's an inside-out coverage there. That's blown. You can't let that receiver on the inside of the field run right down the middle when the safety's playing on the outside. No help to the inside.
First and goal. Houston on the verge of tying it up. Hayes, touchdown. Old Mo has made an appearance, and Houston has him on their sideline. Hogan for the point after in a 14-14 tie. Houston has scored 14 unanswered, and after a slow start, 4 out of 10, Keenum has hit his last 11 throws.
Now Southern Mississippi, after a 14-0 start, maybe they let their guard down just a little bit. You can't do that against a Heisman candidate. These throws have been on the money. They've given life to this Cougar offensive line. And then these receivers at University of Houston, they're going to make you pay for it. Hayes going Superman. Look at the elevation on this. It doesn't take long for the Cougars to score. They have explosive players everywhere, and every snap, you've got to be responsible with your plays on defense.
The passing game coordinator for this offense, and if you understand this spread, which is what most people are going to, you've got a future.
Yeah, he and Jason Phillips have done a fantastic job with this offense.
Lampley on the bounce. 25 and out of bounds. Desmond Johnson, the running back, with Austin Davis. Davis wants to throw and does underneath. Is it a catch? Yes, it is. And good enough for a first down. Dominique Sullivan making his first grab, the former quarterback.
Yeah, I think you better hurry up and snap this ball. This ball's good. This could be, that's a good catch.
Yep,
nice job there.
Went down to get it. They do hurry. And now Sullivan on the flanker screen will get out to the 40.
Nice block, Clinton Pierce. You know, those plays there, 4 and 5 yards, we said at the time, it's like a toss sweep from the I formation for these type of offenses. Very successful, very productive.
Davis down the middle to Sullivan. 30, 20, it's a foot race. Sullivan, touchdown. How about that? 69 yards. And Southern Mississippi with the answer.
Just like that.
Sullivan hadn't touched the ball early in this game, and he's got 4 quick catches, including that one. Make it 3 for 85 yards. And that is a career-long play for him. And all of a sudden, old Mo goes back over to the Golden Eagles sideline.
And Larry Fedora is glad he's there. Now, The disturbing thing is they rush three and they drop eight. So you got to have coverage. You've got a lot of red shirts in the secondary, but nobody's matching up. And the former basketball player, the former quarterback, big, tall receiver, makes them pay for it. You see the talent of Austin Davis and why he's thrown for over 10,000 yards. There's a small window right there on that little skinny post. He drilled the ball right in there.
So Southern Mississippi trying to pull a huge upset here in Houston will take a touchdown lead into the locker room. Craig, you got to hand it to the Golden Eagles.
Yeah, their defense played well, and Davis made them pay a couple of times with some big passes. And so the Cougars offense, they're going to have to come back and be ready.
Let's go to Lisa Salters. Lisa?
Mike, Coach, what did you say to your guys when you went down 14-0?
No, we just need to keep playing. You know, we were just about a half a beat off. We had a couple touchdowns. Downs that we dropped, but we'll keep playing. Our defense put them in a bad position. The wind's a factor with short fields for them and long fields for us. It'll all balance out.
We've been talking about the wind all afternoon. What impact do you think it's had this far?
It's had more than it did during pregame warm-up. Actually, it's picked up and it's getting worse. But we've had long fields and they haven't. Our defense is playing their hearts out, it's all going to balance out in the second half. We'll be all right offensively.
All right, thanks for your time.
All right, thanks.
Mike?
Thank you, Lisa. At the half, our score, Southern Mississippi 21, Houston 14. Now we send you to John Saunders for the Capital One halftime report. Southern Miss had the advantage in the first quarter. Case Keenum came back with his Houston Cougars in the second. And both of these coaches, subjects to the rumor mill and the coaching carousel as we get to that point in the season. It's a 7-point game here at the half. Houston made adjustments to its offense and what it was doing in the second quarter. What adjustments would you like to see them make in the second half?
Well, I think they need to continue to throw the swing passes to the tailbacks out of the backfield, which opened up the inside receivers to the middle of the field. This Cougar defense has got to somehow come out and find a way to limit Austin Davis running the football, particularly the option play. That's hurt their defense.
Southern Mississippi will get the ball first. And they will have the wind advantage in the third quarter. With the wind, 7 points. In the first half against the wind, they had 14. So conventional wisdom goes out the window. Lampley and Hester are deep. Lampley on the run at the 14. Got a seam up the middle if he can get there. Dives across the 30. Check in with Lisa.
Hey, Mike. Well, I talked to a Southern Mississippi head coach, Larry Fedora, asked him what he liked about that first half. He said, you know what, the guys are playing hard, but I do feel like we made mistakes and left some points out on the field. I did say you have to be pleased with how the defense held up against that highly hyped offense. He said, you know what, our defense has felt disrespected all week long. We're just going to keep doing what we're doing for another 30 minutes.
And you'd have to say the defense has played very, very well in the first half.
Yeah, absolutely.
The running back is Desmond Johnson. Instead, it's the fake to him and the quarterback keeper for Austin Davis. And Houston being much more aggressive on that possession. David Hunter led the charge.
Now, with the win, and Kevin Sumlin said this to Lisa going in at half, it surprised him. The win was not as big in pregame as it has become in this football game. It gusts. Sometimes it comes, sometimes it goes.
Blitz coming. They pick it up. Davis throws underneath, and Ballantyne takes it out across the 35 to the 36. It'll be third and about five.
Yeah, third downs are so important. It's the most important thing to Brian Stewart, the defensive coordinator. You got to get off the field, which means you have to be smart. Pressure on the outside corners to take care of their business, but you really have to hug receivers crossing routes on the inside of the field, knowing where the first down marker is.
Houston shows blitz, and they come with it. And the pass is incomplete. You've got to give the Southern Mississippi offensive line a lot of credit. They have done a tremendous job picking up the blitz and keeping Austin Davis from being drilled.
Yeah, that was the time there the Cougar secondary won the battle. They did their job exactly what Stewart was asking of them.
So Edwards will drop back inside his 20. And Bayham set to kick. with the wind at his back. Rugby style kick. It'll take a great bounce for Mississippi State, and if it doesn't hit one of the defenders downfield at the 13, that ball could go inside the 5. It was a 47-yard kick. Jamie Collins had him hit it from behind. Complete to the 42-yard line, Tyron Carrier. Young man who has fought severe asthma his entire life and has still succeeded in a sport where you think he couldn't. Sims with the carry, maybe 2 yards.
You know, the thing missing in this game since early is Cordero Law on the pass rush. Number 49 going off now and get a little break, but this guy was all over Keenum early in the ball game, and that disrupted the passing and definitely got into the head of the quarterback.
Second and 9. Blitz coming, and Keenum hit as he throws. That time they got pressure from McCollum. Desmond McCollum, the redshirt freshman.
Yeah, when you can get it done with only a 3-man rush, you've just won. And the reason they were able to win was because they had timely substitution. You saw how quickly they got out there with that substitution. Took a tired Law out, put a McCollum in who was fresh.
Third and 9. Law's back in. He's on the near side. Pressure coming. Keenum hit again. And no matter how good the quarterback is, that's the key. If you can pressure a quarterback, you can make him inaccurate. You can make him throw it before he wants to.
And you know what? The pocket's collapsing on the middle. So Keenum's having a hard time stepping up and pressing the pocket because the pressure's there. And Southern Mississippi's doing an outstanding job of staying outside lane integrity. There's nowhere for him to run.
They'll have to kick it away. Kicking into the wind, they have averaged 21 yards a kick. That's it. Pressure coming, and they blocked it. They got there. And it's a scoop and score for Southern Mississippi. Furious Bradley with the touchdown. He got the block, got the scoop, and got the score. Holy cow. What a time to put on a punt block. And the crowd, which had been into it, is now totally silent. And Bradley comes up limping. But he's smiling.
Yeah, that's possible. Hey, I tell you what happened now. As a punter, I'm a former punter. When you're punting into the wind and you're having some problems on the day, you think about it a little bit longer. You take a little bit more time. You make sure you have a great drop with the ball. You're trying to get it turned over. You're trying to kick it low and into the wind to have a wind beater. You've got to execute, man. The Cougars, backs against the wall.
That is one Furious Bradley. With that beautiful name and that beautiful play, he has given Southern Mississippi a 2-touchdown lead again.
I tell you what, there's big ramifications if the Cougars were to lose.
Think what happens to Conference USA. They lose approximately $17 million.
It's a lot of money, isn't it?
Ooh. Ooh. Mm-hmm.
I believe they distribute usually around $3 million to each team, so that 17 divided would really make a bigger difference.
Be huge for the conference and everybody in it. And Larry Fedora said he understands there's nobody in the conference that's rooting for him today. Tyron Carrier just lost his footing shy of the 40, almost broken. Southern Mississippi's 2 losses this year. Coincidentally, perhaps, they led both of those by 14 points. They come with a 3-man rush this time. The pass complete to Carrier.
And you know, Mike, that 3-man rush, 4-man rush, 3-man, they continue to mix it up, putting some doubt and confusion in that offensive line.
Ronnie Thornton, number 56, thought he had the interception. This time they come before, and Keenum is hit as he throws. Still got it there. Complete to Johnson. Johnson was wrapped up immediately.
Now this just shows you the composure of Case Keenum in the pocket, knowing he's going to get hit and delivering a well-thrown football into traffic.
Keenum goes to Edwards. Inside the 10.
You saw the cat and mouse game there. Case Keenum beat him. You know, Southern Mississippi was going to go take away the out, and they had the back come from behind.
Cat won again. To the outside, Michael Hayes, and Hayes down to the 1. Whew. Boy, they get pumped up when they're down by 2 scores, don't they?
Man, the senior from East Bernard, Texas, Michael Hayes, has made a couple of fantastic acrobatic runs today.
First and goal. Two running backs with Keenum. Keenum throws for the end zone, intercepted. Darren Wilson picks it off. That is his 4th interception of the season, the 17th for this team. And Wilson, you better believe he was looking for running room, because they have taken 7 back for touchdowns. What a play.
That's one shy of the season record, right?
Yes,
this defense has confidence. They know how to play a very poor thrown ball. This is not communication between Patrick Edwards and Case Keenum. The back shoulder throw is won by the defensive back Wilson. And it's just one of those deals where the ball's up in the air. They're taught at Houston, it's your ball. You go fight for it, and you win it. But that time there, Edwards had no chance. That was first and goal on the 1-yard line.
Somebody's teaching the same thing at Southern Mississippi.
That play was a solid thud, because you had a football team about to go in with a BCS bowl berth on the line. You got a quarterback throwing an interception, trying to get a ticket to New York City for the Heisman Trophy dinner.
Woodyard swallowed up this time. They need to reach the 30 for a first down. He's in the 26. But this crowd, again, stunned, as they have been several times during this ball game. Southern Mississippi, no lay down in these guys. They're not coming in here to attend a ceremony for Houston.
No, in the previous 9 drives, though, Southern Mississippi's only averaged a minute 31 on those. So there's plenty of time for Case Keenum and them to get it back. This defense needs to have a 3-and-out.
Davis tipped. And Houston gets the interception. To the goal line, no. To the 1, Philip Stewart with his 5th pick of the year. How about that? Boy, they needed that, didn't they?
Well, they absolutely did, and this is this result. Davis just stared down his receiver, and a fantastic job of Stewart coming up with the deflected ball. This team makes plays when they have to make plays. You just mentioned the Louisiana Tech time. They had to come from behind, a big-time deficit they had overcome. You don't go 12-0 unless you know how to handle adversity. At some point in a season, in each of the games, you're going to be down. Cougars just showed you why they're number 6 in the country. They're giving themselves a chance.
Well, they blew an opportunity first and goal at the 1. Now they've got a first and goal. They marked him out at the 4. Hayes breaks the tackle. Touchdown. Michael Hayes, the 5'9 senior, gets the score. And with the extra point, it's a 1-touchdown game. Oh. Hogan for the point after. ...28-24, Southern Miss.
Well, the captain of this defense stepped up. Marcus McGraw read the eyes of Davis, came over, deflected the ball to his teammate Stewart, takes it down to the 4-yard line. And then the Cougars offense learned from their previous time on first and goal line. Hand the football off, good blocking up front. Nice run to the end zone.
Lampley and Hester are deep. And Lampley will take a knee. Lampley with a burst across the 40. And a saving tackle by DJ Hayden. He had broken a couple of tackles. If he breaks Hayden's, he gets a touchdown instead of just 28 yards.
The thing about this is that zone read. Remember, you've got to be disciplined on the inside. Take care of your responsibility. If you've got dive back, you go with the dive back.
Lampley again, this time for just about a yard.
And that sets up the quarterback. We did this in the James game. Early on, we showed you the three big options that they had, the threats, the assets of this offense. You hand it, you give it, then you fake it, and you have play action.
Under 6.5 minutes to go, third quarter. Bolden has been very quiet, the flanker who leads this team in catches with 53. Like to screen to him a lot. They haven't done that today. Lampley. And lost his footing. There's been a lot of that today. Boy, Iowa State has broken hearts before this year, haven't they?
Wow. Paul Rhodes is one heck of a football coach.
Yes, sir.
Make no mistake about that. As is Bill Snyder. Man, you're talking about heartbreaking. If Kansas State were to lose as well as Houston, that large berth at stake.
Lampley broke a tackle to the Houston 42-yard line. It's good enough for a first down. Excuse me, Johnson, not Lampley.
You know, Johnson's one of those guys that comes in and gives you that speed, that variety. It's nice to have Lampley back there as well because of his speed to go the distance, with Johnson giving you just a little bit more body size and power.
Johnson, the big back, turns the corner, lowers his shoulder, and has another first down. Kent Brooks took some punishment and made a tackle. Johnson's a load when he gets some momentum going.
Oh, absolutely. The thing that was successful there is it's a tight carpet. It's a slippery surface. Many carriers have slipped today. Johnson planting and cutting with the right foot.
Johnson again on the option read, a couple. If you're thinking field goal, the wind is at their back.
In this game, though, again, like I said earlier, the Cougars are going to get 5 to 6 more possessions. Threes won't win this thing.
Amen. Second and 9. Davis looks to the sideline, tells his line what he wants to do.
Passing on the inside. There's no one over on the slot. Ryan Ballantyne.
Davis looking that way and throws incomplete. Ballantyne was at the 5, but his feet appeared to go out from under him as the pass was a little behind him.
Yeah, and you know, very fortunate now. The linebackers, they were a little confused. This was a poorly thrown football. Ballantyne was the guy, though, that was going to have the opportunity. That should have been pitch and catch.
Big third down. It's 4th and 9. I doubt that they go for it. They've got to bring on the field goal team if they don't hit here. Johnson still on his feet. He's got the first down. He's got a touchdown. What a run by Johnson, and Duhon got a great block for him, as did Dominique Sullivan, the wide receiver. He just picked his way for 17 yards. How's that for a play call on 3rd and 9?
Yeah, and left guard Joe Duhon, they told us that he runs very well. 6'2", 292. When you can get around the corner like he just did there, and the patience of Johnson to allow it to develop.
Well, Southern Mississippi is not going to make it easy for the sixth-ranked team in the nation. They went 80 yards on 11 plays.
Well, yeah, watch this, though. This is a collapse, and they've been very successful running this play. Passing up the end man, a line of scrimmage, has his responsibility. Duhon on the outside just
pancakes.
Oh,
annihilates.
Oh.
If you're the parent of a secondary kid against Duhon.
It's the last thing you want to see is a 190-pound defensive back to see a guy who outweighs you by 100 pounds have a direct bead on you. For another 318, Southern Mississippi will have the wind advantage. Carrier is going to bring this one out. Carrier, so dangerous, finally forced out of bounds just shy of the 35. He has 7 career touchdowns returned, and they have not been able to run against the Southern Mississippi defensive front.
It was so important, too, coming in this game for the offensive line to somehow force Southern Mississippi to bringing 5 in the box and allowing more passing lanes, and they've just not done it.
Keenan with good protection this time goes out in the flat to Hayes. Hayes very close to a first down. It looks like a couple of feet short as they knocked him out of bounds at the 43. They need to reach the 44 and a couple of inches beyond. So it's 3rd and a yard. Sims. No. Hit in the backfield. Now he surges forward, but I thought he was already down.
You got to punt the football. You just can't. You can't play unconventional in a championship game like this, because if you don't make it in a short field for Austin Davis, they'd be in the house. And you've got, this is why the boos are here, but I mean, you remind yourself, Kevin Sumlin knows he's got a very powerful offense that can score quickly. He's just got to pin him back there and have his defense play, do their job.
Clock running, 1 minute 59 seconds to go, 3rd quarter. No rush on the punter this time. Fair catch signaled by Lampley and made at the 19-yard line. As we get down to the most important time of the year, Lampley cuts it outside, first down, and Moore lost the ball. It was touched by a player who was out of bounds before it was recovered. This is going to be interesting.
But it was not possessed by a player out of bounds. Going to be interesting here to see the call. And they, obviously a good run by Lampley right up until the very end of this thing.
If it is touched by a player who is out of bounds, then it's out of bounds.
It's out of bounds. It is out of bounds there.
And it looked like it was touched by 2 or 3 players.
Yeah, and it's going to be Southern Mississippi football.
After further review, the loose fumble was touched by an out of bounds player, therefore it is out of bounds. The fumble was foreign out of bounds. It'll be returned to the spot of the fumble. 1st down and 10 to Southern Miss, and the game clock will start on my 6th.
And when we're critical of officials like this, people have to understand, we've got the benefit of the replay.
Yeah.
They have to call it in live action with the ball on the sideline and guys diving for it and everything else. So,
but a big break for the Cougars at the end of the day, really, because Lampley was on his way for a big run. This Cougar defense got to stiffen up on the inside.
It is a 1st down. And Lampley again. We really found something on that right side. Lampley picks up 4 or 5 yards. And the clock stops the 1:19 mark here in the 3rd quarter.
Ryan Hanks, that tight end on that right side, doing a good job of blocking, allowing a ball carrier to get to the perimeter. But you saw what Stewart did. He brought pressure from the field coming off. That was a run blitz coming. He was trying to guess right, and the ball went the other way.
Davis, double pumps. Now he throws. Lampley's wide open. Lampley. What's the call? Touchdown. 61 yards. And what a throw by Austin Davis with the wind. He just hung it out there.
Yeah, first thing you have to know, though, DJ Hayden was coming, and did the ball cross? It looked like it did cross. Yep. Lampley, that all-purpose player coming into this football game, averaging 126 a game. Fantastic talent.
What a turn of events. Lampley fumbles on a sweep. It's overturned, we think justifiably, by replay. And then, boom, he hits Lampley for what is a go-ahead touchdown and now a 21-point lead.
21 points is not insurmountable, though, for this offense. The question is, can the Cougars' defense find a way to do something with it?
And they're not only going to have to stop them from scoring, they're going to have to stop them from scoring with very little time off the clock, because they need three scores to tie. This will go in the end zone. They're showing three here. If you rush three and drop eight, you take away the big plays. And Carrier with a drop. Well, there have been some big drops in this game. One would have been an 80-yard touchdown that Carrier dropped earlier on a perfect throw from Keenum. That would have been an easy first down and then quite a bit more, perhaps.
That's the third drop by Carrier today, the conference's all-time receptions leader.
Can't blame Keenum for these. Four-man rush this time. Pressure in his face, underneath to Edwards. Edwards with a very short gain. Jerrion Johnson, the linebacker, the first of the tacklers. And you can just see the confidence and the strut of these defensive players. They are taking number six to task. Saturday College Football, presented by Kay Jewelers, will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Moments ago, Kevin Sumlin trying to rally the troops who face now their biggest fourth quarter deficit of the season. 21 points. Keenum under pressure. Throws on a run. What a catch by Edwards.
You know, and I think Kevin Sumlin's got to think about going for this, because this football team's defense is getting thrashed.
I don't think he's got a choice, do you?
Oh, boy, I tell you, this is a tough one here. I know conventional wisdom says, yeah, you punt the ball. The offensive line saying, no, we want to go for this.
Carrier and Edwards are to the near side. They're two most prolific receivers. Keenum looks the other way, throws, and has the first down out at the 35. And it's Justin Johnson with his eighth catch of the day.
Senior comes up big on that. You plant your foot and you know you're going to have to turn, and the ball is going to be there. You got the Heisman Trophy candidate there. You go for it, and they did it.
10:41 left in the game. Four-man rush against Keenum. He throws to Johnson again. Catch number nine. Gets out of bounds to the 46-yard line.
All about rhythm and timing and protection. Case Keenum. Now these wide receivers have to wake up. The one guy that we haven't seen on a big play is 83 Patrick Edwards.
This one, a tough catch for Carrier, can't come up with it. Keenum had him open. Just a quick post.
Hadn't been there today, has a mic.
No.
You know, that combination, which has been so good this season, just has not worked.
And this guy owns every passing record worth owning. Career, single season, just been unbelievable. He's going to need something of a miracle here. Dumps it underneath, this time complete down to the 34-yard line. Geno Collins, only his ninth grab all season.
Like
and
that
he keeps
there.
The drive alive.
Five came, big rush. There's not this pace of this offense right now, not allowing Southern Mississippi to have substitutions, keeping them on the field while they're tired.
Tell you what, there's got to be so much adrenaline coursing through their bodies. I don't know if they're tired. They're on the verge of a monster upset. Pressure coming on Keenum. Throws to the sideline, too high for Edwards. And Keenum is going to have to pick himself up again. There is a flag down, however.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 95. 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Larry Fedora knows that you don't want to let this Houston Cougar offense get in the end zone and the defense come up with one more play. I mean, that's two steps, and he drove him to the ground. Absolutely. A flag.
Khalid Wilson called for the penalty. Keenum, little swing. Sims to the 10. And they had the center, Chris Thompson, downfield throwing a late block, and they've got a flag.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, offense number 7, 15-yard penalty, second down.
Huge.
That's a senior just trying to do all he can, but you have to know that when it's over, it's over. I think it's the left jab that got him.
Yeah, I would say so.
Yeah. And a big body like that downfield, as far as he is, you can't hide behind 170 pounds.
That almost looked like an ejectable offense. Case Keenum has gone over 5,000 yards for the season, his third 5,000-yard season of his career. Nobody's ever done that, ever.
Ball had not reached the line to gain. It was a dead ball personal foul. Therefore, it is second down.
Yeah, he's looking for the first down. Had it been a first down, it would have been a dead ball. Backed him up, been first and 15. But this is over. You can overcome this with this Cougars offense.
They're going to put some time back on the clock. And it's not so much the yards. It's potentially the seconds on the clock. You only have a certain amount of time. You've got to get 3 touchdowns.
It's up to that defense.
And they have not stopped Southern Mississippi. The Golden Eagles have racked up 42 points today. Keenum with time. Sideline tipped away. Excellent play, Marquise Wheaton. They got a couple of good corners on this ball club.
There's no pressure on Wheaton to come off and to cover the flats. He's able to play basically man-to-man coverage with over-the-top help. You know, you have to occupy as receivers all the slots on the football field to make that defense play everywhere.
Third and 16. This is the 13th play of the drive. Keenum with all day toward the end zone and overthrown. Intended for Carrier, but he had double coverage in the end zone. And now you've got to go for it on 4th and 16.
I always watch in a football game to see, one, if there's a football team playing with enthusiasm and speed, and the other is the technical part, the X's and O's. Today, Southern Mississippi's defense has had a fantastic game plan for Case Keenum.
They have been exceptional. This will be his 50th pass of the ball game, and it needs to be on target to keep Houston's dreams alive. Pressure, they got him. Cordero Law with maybe the biggest play of his career. That young man has been pretty darn good.
Watch the spin and the power of this move coming by Law off the edge. He has been in the backfield the entire game. He's picked this team up when they needed it early. And they've had no answer for Cordero Law.
He is a senior from Whitfield, Alabama. And Kimberly Keenum on the sideline can't believe what is happening to the Houston Cougars, who came in 12-0 looking for a BCS bid. The dream is evaporating. And a very down sideline for Houston, a jubilant sideline for Southern Mississippi.
I think the answer in this ball game has really been the running game. Southern Mississippi, 192 yards to 44 for Houston.
Davis, boy, how smart was that? I'm getting rid of this thing.
Not sure he was outside that box.
Not sure he was either.
The quarterback was out of the tackle box when he made the throw.
Nope. Not even close.
He was not outside the tackle box.
Well, that was a big play. That lost it down. And
it is not reviewable, however. I'm really surprised they threw the ball or even thought about it. Lampley. You can take 35 seconds for each play. You take 35 seconds for each play, you're probably going to walk out of here a big winner.
Well, and again, what's at stake here is an at-large berth for the University of Houston that has now opened up the light for a Michigan if they are able to move up a couple. Kansas State if they can hang on. TCU if they can win and move up a couple of spots to 16.
Clock running 8:18 to go in the ballgame. Southern Mississippi would be 11-2 if they win this game. Davis, quarterback keeper. Smart play and a first down. Dives to the 40. There is a flag down in the backfield.
Holding. Offense number 68. 10-yard penalty. Replay third down.
And it's coming back.
About the only thing that's really consistently stopped Southern Mississippi today has been Southern Mississippi.
You pointed out, rightfully so, their running game, and there's the hold. Their running game and their defense have both been exceptional today.
11 flags against Southern Mississippi today. That's, you know, the Cougars just have not been able to capitalize.
Yeah, you're right, Craig. It wasn't like it was a complete collapse by Houston. Southern Mississippi earned this. This was not a gift. Johnson going to the outside, and it was their ability to run against the Houston defense, I think, that made the difference on offense.
Yeah, Baylor's getting ready to tee it up after this game here against Texas. Robert Griffin trying to find a way to get to New York and increase his credentials. Texas's defense, very good. Down here in this part of the country, there's a lot of conversation about who's going to be the next football coach at Texas A&M. If I were the search committee at A&M, on my short list of interviews would be Art Briles. He knows Texas. He knows how to build programs. He built this program. He brought Case Keenum here.
Their first ever BCS bid was there for the taking. And this is going to be a flanker pass by Pierce, and it's intercepted. Zach McMillan picked it off.
I tell you what, that's an interesting call at the
it
end of the ball
that.
Game, up 21, trying to put more on there.
Interesting, yeah. Is
it wouldn't fall in the category of good sportsmanship.
That means Houston with 3:10, technically still alive. Keenan with the screen to Hayes. RG3's been something else. This one's picked by Thornton. Ronnie Thornton on the return. Touchdown. My, oh, my. Insult to injury. When that ball's in the air, these guys go get it. Usually defensive players, Craig, are over there because they can't catch the ball.
Yeah, well, and in this game here, on the inside, Thornton and those guys, the linebackers, have really read the eyes of Keenum and understood the passing lanes and jumped on it several times in this ball game.
That is the eighth interception return for a touchdown this year. That is an NCAA record. What a remarkable season for that defensive unit. They just don't pick them. They pick them and take them back.
Yeah, I'm going to go back to this defense. They call themselves the Nasty Bunch. It's been around that name for a long time. Coming in here, 44 turnovers in this game and 49 under Fedora. They turn the ball over a lot. They get the ball. They're hungry. They get to it. And doing it against Case Keenum, though, was a surprise.
Yeah. Squib kick. Toss it back to Carrier, and Carrier taken down at the 30. Houston right now has been held to 21 points, their lowest game before this. was 37. So by 16 points, this is going to be their lowest offensive output of the entire season. And, of course, they're wondering why now.
And Southern Miss is thinking, why did we lose to UAB?
Yeah.
Now, then the question is different about where they are in the rankings.
That's a good point, because this would make them 11-2. And the two losses in Conference USA is probably going to rule you out of any shot at a BCS bid, of course.
Mm-hmm. I think Case Keenum was glad to be able to get back on the field and not end his Cougars career like that previous drive.
Yeah, get that taste out of his mouth. Three picks coming in all season, all year, as opposed to 43 touchdown passes. He had two today.
So even right there, you've got the passing lane, the defense. They just have a good knowledge of where these routes are being run and what the plays are. You and I saw that at North Carolina State hosted Clemson a few weeks ago.
Absolutely.
They had a great game plan.
Sims will get a first down, momentarily stopping the clock. Only 1:40 left. Yeah. Southern Mississippi defense has a lot of pride. They don't want Houston to score on them again, regardless of how far they're ahead. Well, this, so much of it was a magical season for the Houston Cougars. They had been rated only higher only one time in history. That was back in 1990, and then they lost a big game to Texas. But number six and a chance to play in a BCS bowl has disappeared.
You asked me about how far they would drop. When you look on there, they had to come back in week three and beat a good Louisiana Tech team. But there's no one on that schedule that allows them to have a hiccup and stay up high.
Yeah. UCLA, the only win they had, significant win out of conference. But then UCLA turns out to be a team with a losing record, so that's not going to do you any good either.
Yeah, they'll make someone happy in a bowl, that's for sure.
Well, you get the feeling with Houston going to a bowl, they're going to have revenge on their mind. They might get 100, whoever they play. I wouldn't want to play them.
No. No. There have been teams who've probably played similar defensive schemes, but not have had the success that Southern Mississippi did today.
Yeah.
Just an off day. Good day by the defense, and the drops early in this game, too much to overcome.
Houston trying to get that fourth touchdown with the clock running. And there's the bath. I don't think Larry Fedora is going to mind.
No.
Unless they stick him in head first and hold him there. Keenum out in the flat. Sims gets a couple.
Whew, that was full body. No.
Houston uses a timeout to stop the clock with 10 seconds to go. And I wonder why. Houston trying to put a little window dressing here. Johnson toward the end zone. Touchdown. And the Houston Cougar faithful up and applauding Case Keenum and his teammates. Those who stuck around wanted to do so to give him that last ovation that he has so richly earned in his sixth year of eligibility. 41 of 67 for 373 yards on the day for Keenum. But too little too late against the Southern Mississippi team that came in here and said, you can have all the hype. We want to walk out of here with the trophy. Southern Mississippi has done it. Come into the Lions Den in Houston and took it to the Cougars, 49 to 28. Once again, the final score, 49-28, Southern Miss. For Craig James and our entire crew, this is Mike Patrick saying thanks for watching. Goodbye from Houston, and stay tuned for Baylor against Texas after these messages.